I think the focus is changing in the market. In the past, for 20, 30 years, people come to shows like this to find transaction processing kind of technology. And while everybody out at this show, my goodness, you couldn't even swing a dead cat and not have somebody start using the word bot. I mean, everywhere you go, bot, 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 bot. Oh. What people want now are they're looking for solutions that are going to solve the chief HR officer problems for the year 2025, not for 1990. And there's a big difference. And a lot of the big suites that are out there are still solving old problems around efficiency and productivity. And while that will remain always an important goal of some of the new technologies, the real focus is on how do I grow my business in an outsized fashion, faster, way faster than GDP growth or cost of living kind of deals. And that's got a lot of HR executives bothered because they can't even fill the open spots they have today. So the new technologies, the wow technologies that people want to buy, it's like, how do I get the big data that fuels and primes the recruiting funnel? Where do I get the recruitment marketing technology that helps manage the relationships we're going to have with active and passive job seekers, maybe for years before we need them in the company? And also for those firms in certain industries, they've got some unique challenges. And in manufacturing, for example, we've got HR execs who need solutions that will help them dramatically reskill or replace as many as 85% of their workers in the next 5 years. It's the people issues and both the acquisition, the use, and the skilling of them that are the critical factors looking forward. It's not the transaction processing kind of stuff that we've been so focused on for decades. I think what's really critical, the smart buyers are here at a show like this, kicking tires in the expo hall on things that are going to dramatically remove any kind of manual work on the part of HR people. So this means, I want to have a bot. Seriously, I want bots, but I need really smart bots that have workflow underneath them and exception handling so that a worker, not an HR person, but a worker can just go in, find out what they need, get it done, process, and make it happen. I was talking to one vendor today. A great example of this was their most popular app that they have is the So You Had a New Baby. This is somebody just goes to a chat bot and goes, we just had a new baby, and immediately comes back with a not just the procedure in the book and all the steps that have to happen, but it actually even has a very humanistic deal that goes, well, congratulations. The bot, you know, is congratulating you on that. I said, now, do you want to learn about our family leave act stuff? Do you need this, that, and the other? Here's, would you like to update your withholding and tax exemption information? It has all that, and it will launch all that workflow for you. It's HR designed for non-HR people, and that's a very different approach from the old systems which were designed and sold to and used by HR people almost exclusively. Yeah, I spoke about how there's an expectation gap. And back home in Texas, we have an expression, wanting and getting are two different things. And a lot of what people want, some of all this new stuff that we were talking about just a moment ago, and what they are able to get from some of the old vendors is just not filling the bill. A lot of the old guys they've been around for decades, and I tell clients all the time that sometimes the vendor that has got you through the last 20 years may not be the one that takes you forward the next 20. And in the words of the late dear Abby, sometimes you have to look for true love elsewhere. And what folks are going to find is a lot of the older vendors, they've been distracted a lot lately. They haven't been focused as businesses, and they haven't spent their capital wisely. Some of them, they kind of just recently got in the cloud, and the way they did it was through an acquisition, and they haven't integrated those apps necessarily with other acquisitions or their core product. Or their core product still has a data model that was designed when technology was highly constrained and very expensive. I could go on and on. Some of these companies actually are under a lot of pressure from activist shareholders, and they're doing a lot to return capital back or spinning off pieces of their business, whatever. If you're an old software company, you've probably had private equity investors or vulture investors been circling your firm for years, because in their mind, your company now should be returning capital to shareholders, not burning through more capital on acquisitions or R&D stuff. So the old guys have problems. It's a focus and a capital issue and a product line that just wasn't designed for today. That's their problem. The new guys, they have the usual new problems too. You know, they're small, they're undercapitalized, whatever. There's a million of them here at the show. And the question is, who's going to be the survivor? That's what we all need to know. And that's why we have this gap. We got customers in the middle who don't know whether they should hope and pray the big boys will eventually catch up in time, but I'm not sure they have time to spare on this. Companies need to act and act now. I'm not trying to be smart alecky here, but a lot of people hang on to HR software longer than their marriages last. And so, again, you've been hanging on to something a long, long, long time, and you haven't been actively shopping. You haven't been paying attention. It's got, you know, I have a fun job, and you do too, David. We get to go kick tires and look at all kinds of cool stuff all the time. But going forward, many companies, they just don't know. They don't know. They need to start at the beginning, which is to go scan the marketplace and see and learn what is the art of the possible. And it's not just enough to know that there's new technologies like artificial intelligence, machine learning, bot technology, and we go on and on for 10 minutes rattling off all these names. But you have to also think about, what if I used a combination of like three of these together? What powerful ways can I redesign and reimagine what processes look like? And that's the second step. You scan the market and then you do the reimagination or the thinking piece, and you figure out how we really want to organize and run critical processes. And I think everybody needs to design the future state, the processes, if you will, before they even pick up the phone and call a vendor for a demo or anything else. And then you start bringing them in and start learning what truly can be done today. Right now, there's a lot of vendors that are long on hyperbole and really short on what they can deliver. There's also some new ones that are just flat out amazing, but you may have to scratch the surface a bit more to find some of them. But that's what you need to do. You've got to do the spade work yourself. You can't outsource it, and you certainly should look beyond the vendors that you already use today.